close up stuff.
Oh, yeah.
stuff. It does some cool stuff. Yeah. Hey, like your last one. Hard line drive somewhere, bud.
Strike him out, Eli.
It's
near stream.
Near stream, yeah. It's kind of buggy. Oh, no, it's cheaper than the Mevo.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So I still have the one in there and then the one over there. But bring him around. Yeah, right? Oh, it bounced up and hit him under the chin. No, I am concussed.
I didn't bring my umbrella. Yeah.
Go ahead, moving on, here we go.
A vacation Carl over here. Of course you're staying up here.
So
we got a room up here too. I wasn't driving back, dude.
Thank you.
There you go. Way to put it on the back.
Yep.
good pick. Walk it out.
Thank you.
were both open earlier.
Wait,
yeah.
Where are
you?
I think somebody has shut the door.
Oh.
So if we can find somebody that can open the door, it's probably like the TB SoCal guy. I think has the key. The coaches, at least the guy that kind of put this whole thing together. The juxtaposition of those two things on a baseball field is kind of weird, you know?
Yeah.
Spider-Man. Do a job, bud.
Go, Eli. Originally our game scheduled for tomorrow was at 8. I was like, oh, well that's why I got a room up here. Like I'm not doing a 2-hour drive. I'm like, you know, be here at 7, leave at 5. Did that all last weekend, no thanks. Yeah. How long was it for you guys? Cool. You work yesterday too?
Thank you.
There you go. Look at the glove. Look at the glove. Sure doesn't have a hole in it. Hey, you get credit for that the next inning, though, so that's good.
Pretty sure my kid hates me.
good.
That's you.
good guys.
Thank you. I know you.
Never. Been saying it since they've been like six.
Yes. You don't have to. You can put picture. I can find a tree.
You'd have to hover.
Pitch, I'm back.
So, short stuff. Yeah, someone over there said, that's a ball. He was like, no, it's not. I called tonight. It's enough. It's enough. Oh, yeah. That's right by Eric's car.
Thank you.
happen to have the key to this restroom, do you?
Ah, nice.
This one. That one's open. Yeah. It was open when we showed up, and then I think somebody closed it on accident. And fill it up, bud. separate.
What?
Attaboy!
cheer, bud.
I think it's a subsequent play. I think. I could be totally wrong about that. I'm not sure.
Right. That's what I think. I think it's a separate action, separate play. I think. I don't know.
So bad.
but he didn't care. He got out there, like, he just wanted to talk to kids and, you know, have fun. And, you know, I could only play him in the outfield because he'd get hurt. Yeah, he just didn't know. But he'd be out in left field, and he's, you know, just kind of into it and stuff. Everything went under his legs or over his head. He just, it didn't matter. But he would, during the game, he would creep in. And then, you know, I'd look up and he's standing next to the shortstop. I'm like, oh, man. You know, Brad, back up. You know, like, what? But, so he started to, like, do okay, right? And he had a kind of good game. And he came to practice the next day and he told all the kids, this kid.
Go make an adjustment.
Like, short. It didn't look right. He comes to the guys. Coach called me Brad. Oh, yeah? Like, what is it? Call me Mad Dog. Nah. The only answer to Matt after that. So, you know, you're like, Brent, back in left field. Brent, back in. Mad Dog. Back in. Oh, okay. So, he finally gets on base. The last game, it's like our playoff game or whatever.
Let's go, D.
He gets on base. I think he got hit. And, he would come up to the field on the side of the plate, facing backwards. And, like, it was just chaos, right? But so fun. Like, great kid. So he finally gets on base. And says, all right, Mad Dog, stay right here. Like, don't go anywhere. Just wait for that kid to pitch. You know, don't go anywhere. And he was like, okay. Stepped off the bag. They threw over pick him up. Like, Mad Dog, come on, buddy. But he didn't care. I don't think he actually knew what happened. You know? Like, No. He just was a good dude.
He got out there.
Yeah. I think they just switched. dude that was out there that caught that last ball. So then their freshman, their coach didn't know. Like, oh, well. And I think he was probably messing with them, but Louis was all upset. He was like, he told me he was the worst thing. What's happening with him? That I'm too whatever. And I was like, okay, that guy's an idiot. Like, if he looked at anything you two did and was like, you know, don't just keep doing that. Like,
boy.
He was like, no, colleges look at you. Like, yeah, they don't go to school, so they homeschool for, you know, for a year. Right? They do, you repeat eighth grade. Oh, wow. Yeah. Yeah, no, I mean, they do it all the time. We're in, like, the San Clemente area, and we were getting lunch, whatever, the whole team, and a lady came up, and she said, well, you guys look pretty good. Well, here's my card. What grade are you guys in? Yeah, you're going to need my card. She's like, I do go to lunch school. She's like, so when you reclass next year, just come to me. So I can sign it all off. Yeah. I was like, no, don't listen to this. It's crazy, right? So, but Troy was saying, he goes, she's a certified school. So you give her $300 and she signs off your second eighth grade year. Yeah. That your kid will be 1 year old. I don't know how they do it. I don't know. I think that's why they do the homeschooling. And there's a school in San Diego that's what they do. Like, they're a legit school. Yeah. Wild, right?
Hi.
They're like, no, get out of here. If you're drafted over time. Because odds are you're going to leave them in the middle of their season when you get drafted, right? Like, isn't that wild? Right? I mean, they're eighth graders. But why would you want to repeat eighth grade? Like, pick the most awkward year you could possibly pick, right?
Okay, so I'm at least caught up here.
sort of accurate. Hey, kid, be a great show. Like, make it catches. Like.
Ugly finder! Knock or walk, bud.
Talk right out.
Good game, fellas.